Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 35th Scale Figures in Review. I'd like to take this opportunity once again to thank those folks who subscribe to my channel. We're getting more views all the time, which only translates to more figures we can review, more tools to be used, more paints, and more techniques that we can try to approach and explore those avenues. And with that in mind, I have a special treat this evening because we're going to do a review over Rado miniatures from Poland. These are finely produced resin figures from a gentleman by the name of Radek Puches, who will be at the Mawson Show, which is going to be April 21st and 22nd. This is a famous European show in Hungary, and is simply called the Mawson Show. He's going to be doing some demos there. And these 35th scale figures of his are the After the Battle set, Waffen-SS Winter 44 and 45. I'm really anxious to get into this review, so without further ado, let's get that ball rolling on this episode of 35th Scale Figures in Review. Okay, folks, we'll go ahead and get started with our out-of-the-box review of these good-looking figures from Rado Miniatures. Now, they come in a regular plastic container, okay? Being able to have a folded-up spot if you want to be able to hook it up someplace. The sides are clear, okay? The back is just, once again, just an open box. All right. The very front, of course, is the picture of the miniatures painted, which also, again, would lend itself to be a great painting guide. These are done very, very well in this photo that's taken of the completed figures. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and get this thing rolling and crack this baby open. Okay. Now, there's a two-figure set. So we have one set right here and one gentleman right here. I'll slide the box over and put it out of the way until later. All right. Okay. Now the individual packets for these guys. Okay. This gentleman right here will go ahead and get going. And I believe he is the one with the pea camouflage in the photo. Now one thing that's a little bit unique about what Rado does, which I really like, is that he puts the weapon that's stuck on the sprue, okay, or on the resin carrier in a cardstock backing. That way it stays fairly safe from getting broken, because these can be fairly fragile. And not very often, but every now and then with a resin figure, when you get them in and out, which I do, okay, and it's not the manufacturer's fault, but I'll get them out, look at them, and put them back in. And somewhere along the line, sure enough, the gun barrel or one of the handles will get broken off. This kind of ensures a little bit more safe packing, okay, for this particular piece. We'll go ahead and get him opened up here in just a minute. Let's go ahead and get the rest of this guy moving along here. Okay, and another nice thing about Rado miniatures is they come with two headsets. Okay, here is the set or the carrier with one of his arms. Okay, he has his mess kit, his gas mask, and his canteen sitting right here. Okay, and this is once again the resin carrier. Good job here. Not a whole lot of carrier with the equipment. And I will say, and this has once again nothing to do with the manufacturer, but it's funny, since I've been doing my reviews, okay, the different type of resin that is used by the different manufacturers is all kind of unique in its own little way. I mean, this is all good. But I did notice that one's a little lighter resin, one's a little bit of a darker resin, one's a little softer, one's a little bit more harsh. Okay, this is just fine. Okay, I just wanted to kind of point out that, yeah, there are different kinds of resins that manufacturer will use. Okay, and then this is really nice. Here are the two heads, okay, from Rado. All right, and the carrier is put on the top of the helmet, very minimal. So all you have to do is a little bit of a quick snip and a quick sanding, okay. If I can get a little bit of a close-up of one of the gentlemen, here's this guy right here with the camo and camo helmet cover, and then here's this guy right here without the camo helmet. And of course, we'll have close-ups of all the still snaps so everybody can get a really good look at these guys. And then on to the main character here, the guy in his full body. And this is done very, very well, okay? Obviously, he has a Sturmgewehr 44 as his weapon of choice. And here's the belt. Here, the ammo pouch is done very well. The straps, the harnesses that he has, the folds of his clothing, okay, coming down here, okay. All right, he has minimal
attachment points, again, to the boots. The boots are done very well. Okay, as you see these right here, the folds of his clothing are done nicely. We'll come around to the back to his bread bag that's back here. You see the fold of the hood of his jacket. Okay, comes around, nice creases in here. He's got a nice strap line coming down here, and that is for his gas mask. All right, you see the creases right here. And you know, as you notice, he's only got one arm attachment you really have to worry about, and then the nice positioning for the head. Okay, and I had a gentleman ask me the other day, because what I started to do when you have some of these and you have a single hand or whatever, and I've started to pin the attachments, or excuse me, the hands and the arms in place to add a little bit more stability. What I'll simply do is, I'll show you this, I'll drill out a little hole in the arm socket here, and I would drill out a little hole like right here, insert a brass, little chunk of brass rod, and then put it in, and that allows me to take it in and out, and also adds a little bit more strength to the bond instead of just using your super glue. Okay, and now I'm going to go ahead and take out a Sturmgewehr 44. Of course, I'm being careful once again, because once I take it out of the cardstock, you know, it's on its own. All right, so we'll go open him up here, and voila, here it is, and done outstandingly. Okay, you see, here's the hand. You see on the Sturm, great detail, minimal carrier once again, which means cleanup's going to be a breeze. And as I bring him around here, this would be an example where I would try to put a little bit of a pin in that hand to attach it to the arm. Okay, and here you go. Done very well. Okay, that is figure number one. All right, we'll move him on this side over here. Okay, and now we're going to go on to figure number two. And this gentleman here has the smock, not the smock, the pantsuit that he was wearing. And once again here, great look at the assault rifle, the semi-automatic that the Germans have. Once again, in the cardstock, adds for the safety. Okay, so nothing gets broken. And then I'll go ahead and dump his stuff out right here. Okay, this gentleman, because it is in kind of set in the winter, and this would be typical, a great figure set for Hungary, the Ardennes, whatever, and he has mittens that you'll be able to attach, and if you can run a small line going up, these are attached so that the guy has his freedom of movement, but then the mittens are there just in case the weather gets lousy. Here's his knife on the side, here's his mess kit that's sitting right here. Once again, minimal attachment points, this cleanup will be fairly easy for him. Okay, and here's the two heads again. I can't say enough when these guys come with two heads. Okay, number one, you get a choice of options to put on your figure. Number two, as you, if you aren't already a figure builder, or if you're getting into it, it's always nice to have spares laying around, and these are great. The detail is very nicely done. Okay, right here, the brim of the helmet lays nicely on the head. Okay, this one has the camo on top of the helmet cover. They've done very nicely once again. Okay, can't say enough about the quality. These are excellent figures. Okay, good detail. And then we'll move on to the full body. And this is what I'm talking about with the pockets and the mittens. The mittens will be off to the side. Okay, and his hands are in the pockets. So really, the only flesh tones you're going to have to worry about painting with this guy is going to be the face. Great detail in the front, just outstanding. He's got a scarf sitting right in here. Here's his grenade into the pouch, and you'll see the belt coming around. Okay, he's got the little egg grenades sitting right here. Good strap detail coming up here. All right, that support his belt. Okay, love the folds. Okay, this is just an outstandingly done figure. Okay, the pictures, once again, the video, hopefully speak for themselves. All right, great detail with the clothing, how it lays across coming down, red bag, the pack, and then you see how the hood, okay, opens up. Okay, these are always a little bit of a challenge to paint, but still the detail is excellent. All right, as it goes in here, and then here's the option. You see a little notch in there that you'll be able to put the head in and be able to exchange the head in and out. All right, great job with that. And I'll go ahead and pull out his carbine. Okay, once again on the card stock. out here, and here he is. Okay. Very well done. Okay. Minimal carrier that you see coming down. All right. Okay, great detail, both top and bottom. You know, once again, these will be fun to put together. And I'll be working on that here in just a few minutes. Okay, very nicely done. Now, I will show you this, and just to kind of give you folks a little bit of an idea, and you know, I'm not speaking to the folks that are already into their figures, but here's some of the tools of the trade. Okay, when I talk about cutting things off, okay, here's one of my razor saws that I use. Okay, if I'm going to do some trimming and begin taking the resin carrier away, I line this up, and this blade is two-sided by CMK. All right, has a finer edge and a little bit more coarse side. All right, so what I'll do is I'll lay this guy down and I'll bump him right up by his feet, and that's when I'll be careful, of course, not to dig into the figure itself, but I'll cut it off as much as I can. Okay, and I do this with all the pieces of resin. Then what's left, okay, I will use my nippers here, and I'll just very carefully trim the leftover that's left on the figure itself. Okay, and then of course comes our ever popular and always faithful X-Acto knife with a blade, and I'll just do a little bit of carving on there just to ensure it's done. I'll do some sanding, but with these guys you hear, this is kind of nice. There's very little cleanup. I, you know, to be honest with you, I'm looking at it right here. I don't see anything that I'm going to have to be doing much grazing with a razor saw. Excellent casting. Very, very good. Okay. So that's the out of the box portion of this review. I'll be back in a few minutes with the figures all put together, and it's going to be a lot of fun putting these guys together because they look really sharp. Okay. We'll be right back. Okay. Here's now our assembled section of the video review for these Rado figures. And we're gonna take a look at this guy first. And we're gonna go ahead and lock in my video here so I can get good focus on this guy. Okay, this is the gentleman with the Sturmgewehr 44. Okay, he's got his hands positioned where he needs to be very nicely. We're going to kind of take a slow turn on this guy here. And as we move around, you notice that the detail is done extremely well. Like I said, these pictures of these assembled guys are much better since I've figured out my phone. Here's the hand that I told you that is attached to the gun that I pinned in. And I showed you a picture of that. Here's the folds of the boot that are looking pretty good. All right. Here's the ammo pouches for his Sturmgewehr 44. You see the nice folds in the clothing that he has draped across there. There's a nice look of his face. Okay, as we go here, we're going to go a turn around here on a slow twist. All right, here's his back positioned all ready to go here. And you see the great folds of his clothing once again. Okay, this is his gas can right here, his mess kit. This is the bread bag underneath here. This is the backside. You see the hood. Great detail in the reversible jacket he has. Great strap detail. All right, here's his canteen. And you notice on the backside, once again, great detail of his boots. As we come around here to the front side again. All right, and you'll notice this is one of the neat things I like about this one. If I can get zoomed in a little bit better here. Okay, you see right here, it even has the string detail coming down right there, okay, for his hood. This is excellent. Once again, excellent looking figure from Rado. This gentleman right here has his hand positioned so that when you look at it just right, if you choose to, you can drill out a hole for his cigarette that he can be smoking, okay? Bad habits that they had even back in those good old days, all right? And when you continue to the turn with this guy right here, I can't say enough good things about how these figures look. Outstandingly done. Now we'll go ahead and put him down over here and bring our second guy in. This is his partner in his jumpsuit. Let me get the focus done here real quick. And here we go. Hey, this guy is done extremely well also. You see the nice folds that he has, the clothing. There's his stick grenade. This gentleman's carrying a couple of egg grenades. Okay, here's his ammo pouches for his semi-automatic assault rifle. Here's the strap detail done very well. This guy right here, and I'll zoom in a little bit tighter here too. Okay, this guy has a scarf that he's wearing right here. You can choose the color of that. Great facial detail. And with my figures, one of the gentlemen, the previous guy, had a camo cover on. This guy's got the steel helmet. Okay, his hands in the pockets. As we make that slow turn, you'll notice great draping of the clothing coming down in his one-piece jumpsuit. Now, this particular figure also has mittens that are attached. Now, when I would paint this guy up, what I would wind up doing is putting a string going down, attaching it there, so that way during times he can put them in and put them on, and then, of course, in times of combat, he can pull those off so he can grab his rifle real quick. Now, I am going to show you one piece here in just a minute, and this has to do down here with the bottom of the boots. Okay, I'll go ahead and get a better zoom on this one here too. Okay, and this is gorgeous. Okay, you see the string coming down here in the bottom of the pants that he has, and we'll come over here, do another quick turn, and you can see that even better on this side. It even has the drawstring detail at the bottom of the trousers. Okay, outstanding. We'll come back up here. Look at the backside of this guy. He's got his mess kit right here. His dagger's sitting right there. And there's gray detail in the top of the hood. Okay, wonderful detail by Radek Puchin for creating this figure. Okay, you see the strapping, the great folds as they drape down. Here's his assault rifle. Okay, ready to go. All positioned correctly. Very, very nice. Once again, I can't say enough good things about these Rado figures, this particular set. This is the Waffen SS Grenadiers after the battle set. Okay, so that'll conclude this video of the section of the put together and assembled figures. The still pictures will follow after this. And once again, thanks for tuning in, and hope you enjoyed this episode of 35th Scale Figures in Review.